If you have OSHA compliance questions or concerns, Pike Group's got you covered.
Back in 2011, you know what I mean? They should have took care of it then. There's no telling what's going to happen, and it's too early to tell.
Yeah, it's good. When that water temperature starts to spike, then we'll see what's going on.
We don't want to see all of our fish leave our bay, especially we don't want to see them dead.
Okay.
What else can we do? It's in the mercy of God Almighty and the bloom.
I think this is going to be to be continued. We're going to see what's going to happen with this whole toxic water release. I think probably as the water temperature rises, that algae bloom could really start going pretty bad. So we'll see. We'll get back into this investigation later.
Officials in Florida are scrambling to avoid an environmental disaster amid fears over possible flooding of contaminated water in the Tampa Bay area. A reservoir pond at an old phosphate plant is threatening to overflow into neighboring communities and potentially into the Gulf.
The water is leaking from the pond and it's causing a lot of concern. And tonight, a dive team and an underwater submersible are inside the pond hoping to find a way to plug the leak.
Needs to continue.
Monitor as much as they can.
What they're doing now.
And the unknowns of discharge now, filled with nutrients into Tampa.
The waste while converting the land around the mounds of waste into an industrial park, then ready the site to government and other companies. The records show eight polluted water in place last year. Last week, a representative of HRK, Jeff Barrett, apologized to the Manatee County Commission for the leak.
There will likely be impacts in Tampa Bay. This is very unfortunate, I am really sorry.
Dating, pouring into the bay now.
And we'll hold HRK accountable.
You know, of course, they're still holding the company, HRK LLC, accountable.
But that may not be
The owner of the company, blamed by the state for the Piney Point disaster, is speaking out tonight.
Having HRK come in and do this more than a decade ago. How did that happen?
According to one court filing, in 2001, Ardeman and Associates, an engineering firm working for the state then and now, indicated the greatest likelihood of catastrophic failure was in the stack that has breached twice since then. But according to court documents, the state still sold the property to HRK in 2006 with a plan in place to pump 3 million cubic yards of Port Manatee dredge material into the stack that its own engineers said could fail. 2 years later, in 2008, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers warned the DEP that the Piney Point stacks were not engineered to accept dredging material. In a statement from HRK Holdings, the LLC says in part, despite what the Corps said, HRK was led to believe that the liner and stack system could safely receive dredge spoils from Port Manatee.